So I'm creating a character, World War II guy, a conglomeration of several people I've known in my past, some character voices that I've had over the years, and just some character traits of obviously people I know and what have you.
Just want to say it's ruddy good to see you. Let me see, it's Thursday? Of course it's Thursday. Why? Because yesterday was ruddy Wednesday, that's why. Anyway.
This flat cap I got from Target. It's too new, it's too clean. I need it to look more tweedy. I need it to look older. So what I'm gonna do is age it and color it. I've got some water with tea bags in here. I'm using PG Tips, as only the World War II, the WW2 guy does. So I'm boiling up this water and then I'm gonna steep the hat in the water and for several hours, then I'll let it dry. I'll let it air dry, and then I'll tumble dry it just to secure the color into the material itself. So I'm just waiting for the... This will get really quite dark. And this is, you know, you could use plants. Not so much food dyes, or not so much food colouring, as it will has more of a tendency to wash out. But this would be a great technique, and I look forward to seeing what it looks like after. Meanwhile, I've made another coffee. I got that in my half and half. So I've been stirring, and the water's rapidly coming up to temperature. So I think what I'm going to do is put the hat in. See what happens. So here is the hat that I stained with tea. I dyed it with about 12 to 20 tea bags, and it came out great. Looks more old, looks more tweedy, and very happy. Not bad, right? So that'd be for the World War II guy, his character, his hat. Another prop completed. So, what we making tonight, Dee?
We're gonna make these famous brownies. Yes, they're not. It's not a homemade mix, but I add a little something that makes my brownies better than most people. And no, it's not pot. You know,
I think we should keep it a secret. Don't give the secret away.
No?
No. You think?
No, I don't know. I've given people a recipe and they still haven't. I don't know if they just mix it more.
They haven't done it.
What do you think? I'm all into sharing. You know?
Mm-hmm.
So, we got our bowl. You filming?
Yeah.
So I get this big box. There's four pouches at the BJ's. And this whole box is only like usually $4 or $3.99, depends. Well, that's pretty close. $4, like $4.25 or $3.99. So, yeah, so what you do is, I know this by heart, and I actually alter the ingredients. In the sense of I don't use the amount of eggs that they tell me. So I take two pouches and I'm going to pour them in here after I make sure I get all the...
You know what's handy about this is if I record you doing this now...
Yeah.
If anything, God forbid, was to happen to you...
Yeah.
I'd still be able to make brownies.
That's great.
I'm always thinking...
Because that's important.
I'm always thinking.
Because you were not really a brownie connoisseur before you met me. You I think my brownies have won you over.
They've won me over to the dark side, let's say.
Because it's never been... Like, in other words, brownies has never been your dessert of choice.
No, no.
If I had to say, what is Andrew Jones' favorite dessert? I would have to say... A Napoleon?
Yeah, I think that probably would be. Is up there.
Cheesecake's up there, too.
Yeah, yeah.
If
it's stodgy.
Boston cream donut.
Yeah, that's up there.
Anything with puddings?
Any pudding.
So I'm gonna go to the fridge and get. I only use 3 eggs. It calls for 4 for 2 pouches, but I only do 3 because I don't want cakey like brownies. I want gooier brownies.
I want gooier brownies.
So we do this. And next is, get the measuring cup out. It's 1/2 cup of water.
And meanwhile, I'm going to get the bowl and show the ingredients. So here we have the ingredients so far.
Okay, so 1/2 cup of water. Now, they say a cup of vegetable oil. Here comes the secret. We use, thanks to Cheryl, my mom, we use Bertolli olive oil. And for some reason, when I use Bertolli olive oil, it gives the brownie a better taste, a better flavor.
They are incredible. And no matter where Dee seems to take these brownies, they are often, I would say, a good 90-95% of the time preferred over other types of brownies.
So I'm not, quote unquote, making them from scratch, but this addition definitely does put my brownies in a different category. So we're going to make sure we get all that lovely olive oil goodness in there. Okay.
We need some sniffing.
Sniffing?
No. You know, when you were cooking with your dad the other day and he was all self-conscious about...
I know.
We're going to redo that one, right?
Yeah, because Bob did a replay back, almost like they do on American Idol, and wasn't happy with his performance. So
the next one is going to be a production.
But he's already thinking about other things that he can do.
That's all right. I'll be there. Camera in hand.
Got my grandfather's famous chili for the hot dogs. I heard he made a nice tomato soup the other day.
Yeah, he's a fantastic cook.
My mom was a really good cook, too. Cheryl could make a...
Now, what's the difference, do you think, between a cook and a chef?
What?
What's the difference, do you think, between a cook and a chef? Just professional?
Yeah, and I think a chef, you think of more like...
Like culinary school?
Yeah, like a more finesse type of dish. So I mix it up really good. Make sure I get all the
Hang on, just keep doing that. I'm going to zoom in.
Ingredients mixed. So I cater to people that like brownies with nuts and don't like brownies with nuts. So what I do is I'm going to get my pan and pour 1/2 of the batter in there. So here's one of my trusty, been used a lot, baking pans.
How deep do you think that is? About 3.5 inches? 3 inches?
Maybe 3, 4, 3.5.
Some business card would be a good size to go by, right? Because that's
I just want to make sure.
2.5 by 3.5
Yeah, business just want card. To rinse it out a little bit. Well, there's a business card right there. Is that... What is that, 3 by 5
A business card is 2.5 Oh. Was it 2 by 3.5
Yeah. So I want to make sure this is clean.
Like sizzling.
I like using, instead of using butter and flour, I like to use Pam. Make sure it's thoroughly sprayed.
Brought to you by Pam.
Spray it over the thing. So it doesn't
light a match.
No. So then I just do half the batter in. Okay. Then for people that like nuts, I get this big bag at BJ's. It's like $12, but it's more economical. And I'm gonna put some nuts. Just put a good amount. Probably about
I counted, there was about 216. 216 individual half walnuts.
So obviously I don't do this if I know somebody's got a nut allergy. I don't. Just in case there's a chance you can cross-contaminate, I would make a separate batch for people that were allergic. Make them in separate pans. But, well, this is also the thing, too. Taking two pouches doubles the batter. Most people only do one pouch, and they get a very thin brownie. My brownies are thick.
I like your brownies, you know. They're very good.
Goodness.
Now, why are they calling brownies?
I don't know. I'd have to look. I'd have to Google that.
I'm having a bet because they're brown.
Guess so. Could be something else behind that. Right. So, just gonna put that evenly. Pan.
This is just your way of cooking two batches at once without, with nuts and without nuts. And I have never, when you've cut these up separately, I've never had like a plain one and had a nut in it. You know, they always seem to be well and truly separated.
So your oven's set at 350. Just gonna put that in. 40 minutes, and then what happens is we're going to check it with a toothpick, and if it comes out clean, we'll take it out. If not, we put in a couple more minutes.
So we'll come back when you check it with a toothpick.
That's right. So stay tuned.
Not sure yet. I'll Duncan Hines. Looking mighty fine. I'm going to go in the deeper section. It's still wet in the deeper section. I'm going to go in the shallow. It's perfect in the shallow. 8 So I'm going to put it in for minutes. So the timer's gone off yet again. You ready to take out your delicious brownies?
Let's check it out. You didn't check them again, did you?
I didn't check them again yet.
Let's see.
I would say those are done because the trouble is
it's gonna cook, the tray's gonna cook a little bit.
It's still gonna cook a little bit and the shallow end is done.
Yeah. We're good. So there you have it. These famous brownies with a little help from Duncan Hines.
So we're gonna let the pan cool down a bit. We're gonna cut in. What's that? Moist, doughy. Absolutely beautiful. Well, I got through another Keurig Starbucks Pike Place Keurig K-Cup pack. And these also been collecting them from work. So these are all used. And I'm going to turn these into a battery on the Artistic Brit channel. So actually this video is for the Artistic Brit. So if you stay tuned, you'll see how I turn these into a battery and we'll see how powerful it is. So as you can see, I am in the middle, almost to the end. I need two more Keurig cups. Oh, there's Boo crying out for me. Hi, buddy. I need two more K-cups and I'll have 44 cells, 44 K-cups to make a 44 K-cup cell battery. So it'll be very interesting to see what sort of milliamps or amps or what I'll be pulling when I connect all of these up to make a battery. And I know that I just said battery compared to battery. Battery is how I pronounce it. Battery is me selling out my accent. I do become relaxed enough to, I intermingle it. I don't know why. I think I'm just trying to appease everyone, but the way I would usually pronounce it is battery. Just like when I say soldering, I would pronounce the L. But occasionally when I do the videos, I will say soldering. But in the UK, that would mean something completely inappropriate. Just like a little athlete, that cat. So I'm going to turn these into a battery and I'll show you how I did it right here. I'm going to try and get a bit fancy with this one. So I've got a concept, I've got an idea I would like to put in place so you can watch me build what I'm about to build. I have these little 4x6, 4x5, I think it's 6 inches, little cards I got from Staples. They're separate, they're all just loosely stacked on top of each other. Dee was using a little bulldog clip, as they call them in the UK, And I thought what I would do is use some of my knowledge from my print days when I used to make binders and notepads and all that type of stuff. And all you do is you get some wood or paper glue, weight this end down, and then just get a brush and then just brush on the end. What you don't want is to have too much going in between the pages. So what I'm going to do is I got a little power cord over there. I'm going to place it on the end, and that's going to keep it weighted so the glue doesn't go in too far, because otherwise you won't get a clean perforation. When you tear the card away, the top card. So I'm going to show you how to do it. So I literally have the camera propped up on a bunch of stuff I probably shouldn't be propping it up on, but it seems to be steady. So what I want to do is weight down the edge. I want to square everything up first. And I'm going to stop squaring on the edge that I'm going to glue. I'm going to hold tight. I feel a bit like dyslexic today. I'm just going to slide a sheet under so the glue will get on the sheet and not the countertop. And I'm going to straighten up this edge just a little bit more. That's good. You know, I don't want to make it rocket science. Put it about an eighth of an inch away from the edge. Get it so it's balancing nicely. Then I'm going to weight this down. I'm probably going to use this glue jug because it's pretty heavy. I'm going to pour some glue into the cap. It literally only needs just a little bit. I'm going to dip the brush in it. This brush has been used for all sorts. It's on its last leg, so I'll be throwing it away after this. I could rinse it out and use it again. So then push down. And just make sure you cover the area. You know, this isn't a great brush to be doing this with, but and I'll let this dry, and once it's dried, I'll probably just put on another couple of layers just so it gets nice and thick on the end. It won't, after this initial layer, it won't stick anymore, but looking good. That's nice. I'm actually going to soak this cup. I'm going to soak this this brush in water. I'm going to find something to put it in. Before I do that, let me Okay. It's all about precariously balanced things today, I think. So that's in there. I mean, what you could do is... it's already drying. Okay, so that's done. Let's come back in a few minutes and
see what it's like.
Here, the it's dried. It's maybe an hour later. Works good. Just peel off a page now, which is fantastic. But what I'm going to do is just put another layer of glue on top, just to make it a healthier bond. But other than that, I mean, it's done. It's just a great way of making a pad. But the key is not to let it soak all the way in too much, which is why you need weight down on the ends just to stop it from completely soaking in.